I'll be mistress. Elvira, Mistress of the Dark. That's right. And I'm doing the show. And the show, as you know, is called Elvira, Mistress of the Dark. And I am also called Elvira, Mistress of the Dark. Yeah, that's right. Because, let's be honest, it's all about me. That's right. All about me. That's right. Okay, and besides, we did some research, you know. And it turns out that most of my fans can either remember my name or the name of the show, but unfortunately not both. Yeah, I blame the Russians. Okay, let's hear it for Mama Cobmobile. Well, yeah, we have been around together for a long time, and I gotta tell you, we have a lot in common. We both have high beam headlights. We both have little body work done. And despite racking up a crap load of miles over the years, our engines still both purr like kittens. Whoa. Hey, sound dude, that was very funny, but you know what? When I want your opinion, I'll what?
Yeah!
I'll beat it out of you! Thank you. Okay, let's hear it for my set! Yeah. Not that set, I mean this set. Dig that opening number? Yeah, yeah, you know, I told those dancers that if they didn't get their moves down, there would be grave consequences. Get it? Yeah, and speaking of graves, see what I did there? With that. Speaking of graves, this year's show actually has a plot. And no, honey, it is not a cemetery plot. That's right. No, it's all about this bright-eyed and bushy-tailed actress who... Oh, God, bushy-tailed. Hey, that reminds me, I'm gonna make a waxing appointment. Bright-eyed and bushy-tailed, aspiring young actress who makes her way across the country and ends up here in beautiful, sophisticated Buena Parque. That's right. And for the three of you out there who do not speak Spanish, that means good park. As opposed to parking Mambo down the street, you know, in Anaheim, that place with the mice infestation. Oh well. Speaking of park, I think it's time for me to park my ass sets right over here on my signature sofa. And do what I do best. No, not that, you perv. This ain't no casting couch, okay? What do I look like, Harvey Weinstein? I take that back. Okay, this looks like it's gonna fit four comfortably. Not seated, that's for damn sure. Okay. Okay, boys, I'll see you after the show, all right? Later. All right, okay. I tell you, sometimes those dancers are harder to get rid of than herpes. Okay, now it's time for me to show a bad movie. But this time, it's not a bad movie. It is actually a masterpiece because it's all about my meteoric rise to the middle. That's right. So just in case you guys don't know who I am and you just ducked in here to take a load off, you know, and get away from the homicidal clowns, well, you are going to find out who you're dealing with, okay? So everybody just sit back, relax, put your legs up on the person in front of you, and let's take a trip down memory lane. I was born at a very early age to poor white trash parents who were so old-fashioned, I wasn't even allowed to wear makeup until I was 3 months old. The 15 years I spent in grade school were some of my happiest times. But like all kids, I went through that awkward phase, which sadly continues to this day. During the swinging 60s, I tuned in, turned on, and dropped out of high school, where I was voted most likely to by the entire football team. Right out of school, I joined the military, where I served directly under General Storman Norman Schwarzkopf in Operation Panty Shield. Time after time, I went down behind enemy lines, single-handedly winning the war. After serving my country, I did what any red-blooded American hero would do. No, I didn't go into politics. I went into TV, becoming one of the most sought-after thespians in the business. I said thespian. Having successfully hosted my own show, I left the roller coaster world of television for the real roller coasters here at Knott's, where I quickly became the most popular ride. Well, they don't make men like that anymore. Wow. Realizing that opportunity only gives you knockers once, I decided to display my big talents on the big screen by starring in my very own Robustus Blockbuster.
She's everything you've ever wanted in a movie. A woman and a casserole.
We got us a couple more volunteers.
Great, just grab a tool and start bending.
Elvira, Mistress of the Dark.
Around, but don't worry, I'm still happening, I'm still groovy, I am still hit. As a matter of fact, I have two new hips. You want to see them?
I'm just a big blue girl in Buffy Moulding from the Buena Park Official Organization for a Better Society. Here in Buena Park, we value good morals and good manners. And as good citizens, we feel it is our duty to peek over the fence and see what's going on in the backyards of our fellow Americans. So you can just imagine our shock and disgust when Knott's Berry Farm, the family-friendly home of hot pies and juicy breasts, decided to disgrace our community by hiring the Halloween harlot known as Elvira, Mistress of the Dark. Time has come for the decent people of Buena Park to rise up and denounce this overly made-up man-eater, this tart-tongued trollop, this jiggling Jezebel with junk in her trunk, and all that makeup she wears. Relax, my dear couch potatoes. There is no need to polish your pitchforks or light your torches, for I, Buffy Moulding, and my army of morally superior filth fighters are taking care of everything. Oh, and the great news is that it all coincides with our annual book burning and pancake breakfast. So we're really multitasking. Get her, boys!
Ah!
sized.
Isn't it great how when it comes to the battle between good and evil, things always seem to turn out the way they're supposed to?
Club, where their motto is serving the children of the world as an entree. Now, good citizens, we gather here every year to put to death the most heinous, horrible, and hateful among us by hanging them from the neck until they're dead.
Let's go to Salt City!